So we'll see closure management today. First part. The later we'll see other things also. Okay. So first of all, how to create a closure? Simple command is, first I'm telling a basic commands, then we'll start using one by one. User add. User add is a command to create a closure. How to modify user? How to modify user? The command is user mod. Okay, how to delete user? Okay, how to delete a user? User del. User del. No spaces. User del. Of course, here is the options also there. So with the options also, I will explain it. Okay. My word model of explanation is onboard directly explain the command instead of typing the command on the terminal. Okay, so we'll try this one. So how you will get it also we'll see. Okay, so next guys, there is a three files are very important files are there. So one is user information. Stores in a file called /etc/passwd. Well-known file, right? So we practice a lot of things on a passwd file also. So this is the contains user information. Next, group information. Group information stores /etc/group. This is another important file. Next, password information. Password, user password information, user passwords stores /etc/shadow. Shadow. These three files are very important files for every time. For a first initial you are starting learning, compulsory verification is important, guys. Verification is important, observations are important. Okay, before you do, after you done, compulsory you should do the verifications. If you simply sir, I want to know the command, just give me the command, I will type it and leave it. If you want to learn like that, okay, it's okay, learn. But you didn't learn the Linux actually. You don't do, that's a no use of that Linux. Okay, you will forget what you are doing it. Okay, so that is an important one. Okay, these are the three files are a user information file. Of course, every system has a group. Every user is a member of a group. So how to add these groups is adding a group by using a command called a group add. Okay. You want to delete the group by group del only. Okay. Of course, there is a modification of group, like a group IDs and all. We can modify the group using group mod also there. Okay. Next. Guys, look at here. First of all, I want to display last two lines. Which command? In the /etc/passwd file, I want to display last two lines. Tell me the command. Last two lines. Very good. -2. Last two lines. Okay. So I have a student one and student two. Two lines are there. Okay, because I created another thing is student one. So I'm copying this one because student one I created when I created virtual machine time. Okay, so I want to explain with this one. Guys, look at here. The first one is username. The first one is your username. Second, X means password. X means password. So it does not mean X is the password. Okay, it represents a password. That's it. The second one is user ID. The 1000 is nothing but a user ID. Next one is group ID. Next one is group ID. And this is just a name only. It's a name concern only. Student one, this part is only just a text. It is does not do anything. Okay. It is like a full name, a particular name, is like a comment. Actually say it is like a comment type. For example, HR. Username is something. Vishal is there here. So Vishal is a software engineer. Okay, or maybe like a particular department. Okay, like that also we can able to create. This is the users home directory. I will put a, we know it is a user, belongs to user only. It's a home directory. Okay, next it is a login shell. When you log in, so you log into bash shell. You log into bash shell, so it's a bin bash. Okay, if you look at other, no login shells also there. You can see has been no login. It means this particular user account or this particular account. Okay, this particular account is there, but no login. It cannot log into system, but these are login accounts. So when they log in, they will get a shell prompt is will be appear. So guys, this is the information. Okay, so here it is. When you go to what I type, catertail tail minus two slash etc slash pass wd. So this is the line is appear. The meaning of line is the first one represent your login name. Login name. So this is the account with log with name. This name only will login. Okay. Login name or user name. You can say user ID, group ID, and this is the comment. Next home directory. When the user is login, there is a home directory for that user. And this is the login shell. So when they log in, so they will get a this kind of shell. Okay, bash shell. So shell kernel and shell. This is the bash shell. Okay, like this. So next important one is, remember every user in Linux. Okay, every user must have a password. Without a password, you cannot log in. Okay, every user must have a password and must have a password and is a member of a primary group. Okay, a group, the primary member group. So is a primarily is in a one group. Okay, I will explain what is that a primary group, secondary or a supplementary group. So member of a primary group must have be in a group, must be in a group. Okay, must have, must be in anything. Okay, so remember these are a compulsory things. Must have a password, must be is a member of a group. Remaining is common. User ID is a common thing. Next one is home directory. Compulsory home directory is required. If you don't have a home directory, you cannot log in. You will get a single shell mod, that kind of stuff. It means no home directory person. Compulsory, every user must have a home directory. Guys, when we are using Red Hat 4, Red Hat 5 earlier versions, when you are creating a user, you must give all these details manually. All the details compulsory you should give manually. Nowadays it is not required. Okay, next. First point I will tell how to add a user. Okay, first command is I will tell how to add user, basic thing, and give password, right? Give password. So this is the first we'll see, guys. First of all, you want to add a user, means what is user add command? User add. Next thing is simply give the username. So I'm giving a username is user one. am giving username is user1. So compulsory verify. Whenever you adding a new user, the user must not be there. Must not be there. So that's why you should verify how many users in your PC. So check the usernames. The usernames, the users should not be existed earlier. Otherwise, it will throw error. This is user add. After adding a user, what to do? Tell minus 2 or minus 3. So I will put a minus 3 for me. Slash etc slash false wd. Verify user is created or not. Next one is ls space hyphen l slash home. Home directory is created or not. That is also we should verify. So these are verification commands, but I want to give username. Passwd user1. Guys, never type a passwd enter. If you enter a passwd just enter, you are changing your current user password. Current user password. See, passwd, just enter. Then automatically you are going to change the current user password. Meaning is, you are doing all this work with the root, you are changing the root password, and accidentally you change the root password and you forget about it, then there is a big problem. Okay, you can do when you are free with if you are ready to install another new virtual machine, it is okay for now. But my point is, be responsive when you are doing some mistake. If there is a really problem is occurs, you can try for a solution. Okay, so like this, you can put a 3-1 or anything. Okay, no problem. So first of all, add a user and give the password for that user. Okay, this is the basic thing. Add a user, next give the password for a user, and it will ask the password 2 times. Okay, yeah, it will ask for the password, type password 2 times. Okay guys, for a now, for a currently, what to do? Give the password as a user one and user one only. Okay, password 2 times, user one only. Same as a username, give it. Okay, next, these are the verification commands. So first, verify your user is created or not. It is created because you, when you give in this one, it is there, but check the details. Check the details. Next, home directory is creating. Next one is trial minus 3 slash etc slash group. Next, tail minus 3 slash etc slash shadow. Okay, you can put a minus 1 also. Minus 1 is also okay because we need a last line only. We don't need all the lines because I have other users also there. So I'm using like this. Okay, you can use minus 1. So no problem. Okay. Nothing danger will occur, guys. Nothing danger will occur. Guys, there is a difference. This is minus 1. This is minus L. This is L. This is 1. Okay. Both are look like a same. But smallest difference is there. Observe it. Okay. This is first part. We'll create a user. We'll give the password. And we'll see all this kind of stuff. One more is there, ID user one. Okay, these things we'll see first. Okay, what it is? Yeah, tell me.
Shadow.
What is shadow? Shadow means user's passwords and password related settings stores in a shadow. Here it is, user passwords and user password settings. Okay, stores in a shadow. Okay. Linux, everything is a file. Everything is a file. So one by one, we'll see. Okay, look at here. So first of all, I want to add a user. Before going to add a user, I have to verify may I have any users are there, existing users are there. I want to check it. I have the last two users are there, as you know. Otherwise, you can put a three, no problem. Put a three. Yeah, starting with the student one and student two. Two users, main users are there. Already two existing users. Student one, user ID is 1000. Student two, user ID is 1001. And group ID is 1000. And group ID is 1001. Okay, I will explain this group ID and all. So don't worry. The first task is adding a user. User add user one. User add user one. Enter. User is added. Want to verify user is added or not? Look at here. No. So we don't verify. So just I'm giving a password. Because this is simple. Okay. I'm giving a password. User add user one. Pass WD. User one. Then it is asking, giving a new password. Pass WD for changing a password or assigning a new password for it. And I said, always I try to give password as a same username only. So because that's why we don't forget it. And of course, it's a bash password. We need a 7 characters minimum for a giving a password. So, but when you give in a password both the times correctly, so that is all authentication token update successfully means you've given a password. You've given a password. So user creation is completed. User creation is completed. User add, user one. Pass WD, user one. And I've given a password also. Now it is completed. Now thing is verify. Verify. Verify whether user is created or not. And what are the details about it? Look at here. User 1, user ID is 1002, group ID is 1002, and there is a no comment here. And home directory is /home/user1 and /bin/bash. One more, I said ls /home/home is a directory which contains users. Home directories, users home directory. So if you observe it, student one, student two, user one, these are the directories. These are the directories in my /home directory. Under /home directory, these are the home directories are created. Okay. Next one is another verification is verify group. Verify group. So this is the group names, not a usernames. Guys, remember, I'm verifying a group. These are the group names. Student one is a group, student two is a group, user one is also a group. That one is 1002 represents group ID of user one group. I will tell why both the names are same. I will tell that one. But look at this thing, okay? Okay. Next, shadow. Shadow. What is a shadow? A password related file. Okay. So I need a big screen for this one. So look at here. This is my user one. And this is my password up to here. This is my password. I given a user one. Just the user one, user one. That is a password I given. But see how big it is. Why it is very big? Because of it is encrypted. It never stores in the plain text format. Password stores in the system in an encrypted format. In the encrypted format. So what is this 6? The 6 represent. So the level of encryption. The 6 represent. Level of encryption, how much level it is, level 1 encryption, level 2, level 3, level 4, like SSA algorithm is there, no? So that's levels of encryption. This is a minimum password age and this is the maximum password age. This is minimum password age is a 0, maximum password age is 99999. So So this is the maximum password age in the days, in days. 7 represent warning. 7 represent warning. So how many days before a password will be expire? So that is the 7. Okay. This is this is a time, like a number of years, a number of time, like that. It represents a time. So simple. How much older, like that it is. Some number is there. Okay, guys, this is your password.
I have a doubt, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Sir, you typed ls-l slash home there.
Very good.
Okay, sir, you got total 0, so I get total 4. What is this? And also, you got student 1, student 2, and last you created user 1. Sir, I got first the user 1, and student 1, student 2. Last.
Okay, no, not a big deal. Okay, the total means is usually like a size and links, link counter, like that it will shows. Okay, this order is depends upon your system. Last like this it will shows. Maybe any caps are there, look at one. Okay, actually it must show some size. That's not right. Even a lot of people think this 0 represent number of files or directories here. No. Okay. That 0 represent different one. Very good. Where am I? Yeah, here it is. Student 1. Okay. So this is about your shadow. Guys, are you clear? Yeah, one more command is there, id. I'm not copy pasting any output or kind of stuff, just the commands which is I've written earlier, same commands I type here. So last one is id user 1. It is, if you are observe here, ID user 1 means username. User ID is 1002. Group ID is 1002. And group name is user 1. Groups. So user can be in a one group and multiple groups also. But minimum one group. Minimum group is primary group. Why do you didn't get a details? One second. Yeah, that's the difference. That is already I told. It is not one. It is L. This is L. That is one. Very good. Okay, L. Now try.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so a user can be in a multiple groups. Guys, look at now. See, here it is. This is user 1. Already I told every user must be a member of a group, a primary group. Okay, compulsory primary group. This is PG, primary group. So I didn't mention, I'm creating a user, but I didn't mention which group user should join. What I said, I didn't mention which group when I'm creating a user. Sorry, when I'm creating a user, the user must be joined in a group, right? When I'm creating a user, the user automatically joins in a group, primary group. But if I didn't mention which group it is, what will happen? System creates a group. System create a group with the same name as a user. Okay, this is user side, this is the group side. See what happened when I didn't mention which group the user is should join as a primary group and in a primary group. Okay, so I didn't mention when it is creating. So what it is doing, system creates a group with the same name as a user, like this. So my user one's primary group is user one only. Okay, my user one primary group is user one only. Okay, remember that. Next, guys, for example it is a step by step, so slowly understand. For example, I created a group. My group name is group one. I created a group. My group name is group one. First of all, I create group. First only I created a group. Okay. So my already group is there. Now I want to create a user. So user one is already created. So I'm going to create a user two. Okay. So I'm going to create a user. Username is 2. And when I creating this user, so when I creating, while creating, while giving a user add command, I told join in this group. I told join in this group. So obviously user two group won't be created. Obviously user two, group name is user two, won't be created. So this is won't created. Directly it will join into the group because I am mentioning it. How to mention it? By giving an option called -g while I am creating. Okay, so this is the command. Look at here, guys, look at. So first add a group. First we have to add a group. So group add. Group name is group one. Group name is group one. Next, I want to add a user. And users primary group is group one. Okay. This is add group. And this is the command, guys. Said check the difference between command and this one, otherwise I will give some thing like that, some representation for that one. Okay, so next one is group added. Now I have to add a user, and users primary group is group one. So what is the command for adding a user? To add a user, what is the command?
User add.
And user two. Okay, but I said there is an option -z group one. Okay, so if you observe this one, when I'm adding a user, I didn't told anything. By default, things are created. But here, I'm specifying add a user, and user's primary group is group one. Okay, so we'll try this one. And remember, guys, once you're done, before you done, verify. After you done, sorry, before you do, verify. After you done, verify. What to verify? These three files compulsory. ID command and this one. Okay, So we'll see that things. We'll look at here. I'm putting it clear. First, verify. First, I'm going to create a group. So make sure that the group should not be created earlier. So you can put a 3 or a 4, no problem. I will put a 4 slash EPC slash group. Only I'm checking group first. So student 1, student 2, user 1, group is there. Next, fail space hyphen 4 slash etc slash pass wd. So these are the users. Now I'm going to create a user. User add user 2. So what I said, add a user, but add a user to group 1 group. So don't give this one. So don't give this one. First of all, we have to add a group. What is the command? Group add group 1. Group add group 1. First add a group. Group is added. How do you know group is added? How do you know group is added? By verify. Verify group is added or not. So group 1, and that is a 1003 is a group ID. Group is added. Yeah, you can create a number of users, no problem. User add hyphen z group, group 1, sorry, hyphen z group 1 and username, enter. Now user is created. How do you know it is created? So by verifying pass wd file. Okay, so user is created and it is giving a confusion because user ID is 1003 and group ID is also 1003. Then put a ID user 2. So can you see the names? User ID and username, group ID, group name and groups. So this is how to add a user to a particular group. And I got a question, so then we'll see that one also. I want to add a user 3 user. So where is my picture? I want to add a user 3 user, and while I'm adding a user, user must be added to this group only. So no need to create a multiple group. Group means having a so many users. So here it is. You can add a number of users to single group as a primary group itself. Okay, so this is added a user to a group and verify. So how to verify? See, user 3, user ID is 1004, but group ID is 1003. So user 3, user 2, see, their user IDs are different, but group ID is the same. Means user 2, user 3 are in a same group. Yes, you can add a user 1 into group 1, but not with the user add. Why? Because user 1 is already existing. You cannot use the command user add again. You have to use the user mod. Okay, put that question like that only. I will tell how to add it also. Primary group, secondary group, like that I will explain it. Guys, understand? Group adding. Of course, you have to verify ID user 3. So user ID 1004, user 3, group ID 1003, group 1, and groups are group 1 only. So this is a how to add a user and a group. The last one I want to show you, that is group. Last but one. Group 1 is showing can we edit user IDs? Yeah, you can change the user IDs also. You can change the user IDs, but these user IDs are by default. Okay, I didn't give any user IDs here. They're by default, it is generating. If you want to give a particular user IDs, a series of user IDs also, you can give. Okay, yeah, guys, look at here. Student 1, student 2, user 1, group 1. These are the groups. But where is the group members? We can't see the group members from here because all the members are primary type only. Okay, it's a primary. Remember, groups are not primary, users are not primary. I said primary, but nothing is primary here. Primary means the main group. For a user, this group is primary. For this user, this group is primary. For this user, this group is primary. This is not a primary group. This is not a primary group. For this user, this group is primary. Remember that one. Okay. Where are we last? User add -z.
Recording in progress.
Sorry for the disturbance. Okay, so this is how to add a user to a group. And of course, we seen a group, but there is a no user kind of stuff here. Only group name is there, group ID is there, username not sure. So I will tell why it is in the next part. Okay, in next part means once we verified all the things. Only one thing, like a shadow. So guys, this is a user 2 and user 3, and this is user 1. Why user 1 has a very big this encrypted data is there, and why user 2, user 3 showing a like this? Why it is? Any guess? Just guess it.
It does not create password for user 2.
Very good, very good, very good. We didn't given a password for a user, then obviously it is not showing any password here. If you give password, then only password will encrypt and store. So first of all, how to give password user 2? That's it. Password for a user 2. Tell me the command.
Password user 2.
Passwd 2. And give the password. Now, I given a password, so just verify. Shadow. Now, can you see this one? So that's the difference. I didn't given a password for user 3, so we'll see that one later. I mean, we'll see the difference if you don't give password, what will happen? Okay, so like that. Here it is again. I am going back, guys. Only small part. So first one is to create a user. Command is user add. To modify the user related things, user mod. To delete the user, user del. Okay. Always verify few things. One is /etc/passwd, where user information stores, username, user IDs, group ID, user's home directory, and login shell. information in a PassWD file. In a group, group name, group ID, and secondary group members. In a group, it shows secondary group members, not a primary group members. Okay, I will tell the difference also in here. Next, shadow file stores user passwords and password related settings also. Next one is how to add a group, group add. How to delete a group, group del. How to modify group, group mod also there. Okay, next. So first of all, we have to verify what are the users or existing users. Make sure that what are the existing users are there. Okay, next. Every user must be there is a user ID, group ID, and this is the comment. Comment is a optional one. Home directory and logon shell. If you want to create a user with a particular modifications, also we can do with the modifications also. I didn't give any much options here, but I will tell the options also. So just wait. So when you create a user, you must give a password compulsory. So very simple, you can create a user with a user add username and a passwd username, and it asks for a password 2 times and then give the password. Next. Tail iPhone -1, so you know that one kind of stuff. Verification ID is one of the important command to know. So what are the output, you can understand. So next, here I created a user and I given a password, that's it. And when I verify the username is a group also same names. Now what I think, I have a idea of a group. For example, CSC people are there. Okay. For example, Akhil. Belongs to CSC group. Like that. CSC is a group. I create a user, Akhil, and put into a group. Manikanta. CSC group. So many people are there. Vishal. CSC group. This is single group. For example, Ranjit. So Ranjit is mechanical group, for example. Mechanical group. Shubham. Mechanical group. So I create a group called a mechanical first, then I will add a users to that one. Like that, we can do it. Next is an important question you guys ask. So after you create a user, like I created a already user one, already created user, group name is user one. Can we modify the user? Yes, we can able to modify. Okay, but that is I will show you in the after a break, because already it is little loaded, but we'll go with a user mod to do that one. Okay, and user mod, and there is a certain options for a user add and user mod also, guys. Hyphen u for a user ID. Options almost same for both the things, like a user add. Okay, option is you want to mention a particular user ID for a user. Hyphen u, hyphen z. For mentioning a group ID, it means primary group. You want to add a user to a primary group, hyphen Z. Hyphen capital Z is like a supplementary group. Supplementary group. We can say secondary group. Okay, secondary group. Hyphen D means changing of home directory, specifying home directory. Maybe home directory not always required to be slash home kind of stuff. You can specify a remote home directories also. Hyphen D. Hyphen S. Login or logon shell, it represent login shell. Very important, yes. Hyphen L. Login name. Want to change the username. Hyphen IR, hyphen L is there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hyphen C. Comment. Okay. So when you are doing it, when you are adding a user, you can use certain things like this. So you can use certain options to create a user. So for example, user add hyphen u 1500 group ID. I'm specifying a particular group ID. Hyphen z group one. Okay. Hyphen d slash home. Slash home slash I need a Vishal. Okay, Vishal directory. Okay, next login shell is not much. I fancy Vishal Chindam Vishal. You can give the password also here, hyphen p, but it won't work. Don't worry, it won't work. You can specify the password also. How to know these are all options? What to do, guys? User add. Well, these are all options, you will get it. You want to read about options, what I given? Go to help, find out what is this, what is this, what is this. Hyphen E, expiry date, hyphen F, inactive, like that. Lock, unlock, okay? Lock, unlock kind of stuff also there. So, that is it. This is it. Just take a 10-15 minutes break. So, we'll be back. So, back at 12:15.